My name is Alan Isner. I'm with the Wildlife Resources Division, working in Southwest Georgia, where the division has identified four wildlife management areas down here: Chickasaw Hatchie, Elmdale, River Creek, and Silver Lake, to do quail management on it. We're looking at a 10 to 15 year project to try to get that habitat back to what it historically would have looked like. The way this is going to change from what the hunters are used to seeing is they're more used to seeing a stand with a lot of trees in it. What we'll be doing now is we'll be taking out a lot of those trees. So it'll be more of an open, grassy, shrubby, understory component that'll provide a lot better habitat for the deer, turkey, quail, and other small game by providing escape cover, forage, and nesting habitat. If you take a field and it's bare dirt, you leave a field alone, over the first few years it'll happen in that field, it'll grow up in weeds and grasses. As you continue to leave it alone, it'll grow up in trees. And if you keep leaving it alone over time, what'll eventually happen is it'll grow up into real thick, heavy cover, overstory cover, with very little things growing on the ground out there. That's what we call succession. And when you talk about early successional habitat, the goal is to keep everything at that very earliest point in that development where you get some young plants growing out there. Those are what deer and wildlife need. What we're having to do to bring these late successional habitats back to an early successional stage, one of the very first things is we've got to take trees out of there. Whether it's pine trees or hardwood trees, we've got to get those trees down to a far fewer trees per acre. And we're using steps, either mechanical thinning, selling the trees. If the trees are not merchantable, you're using herbicides to remove some of those trees to get them out of the stand, to get that total number of trees per acre back down lower so we can get a lot of sunlight onto the ground to promote that early successional habitat. And then after we do get that early successional habitat in there, then we come in there with fire. And that's the ultimate goal, is to get it to where everything is fire maintained. And then after we get it to fire maintained, the only thing we would have to be doing at that point is, as the pine trees grow, we might have to go in there at a later date again and remove some more of the pine trees. We don't have catastrophic wildfires anymore that naturally remove pine trees. We have to go in by mechanical means and mechanically remove those pine trees. When I talk about catastrophic wildfires, I'm talking about wildfires that don't burn just a few hundred acres. I'm talking about wildfires that went across the landscape for thousands and thousands of acres, uninterrupted by roads or anything like that. And when those occurred, it would naturally thin out pine trees. So our wildlife that we have in this area thrived and did their best in those type of habitats that were frequented by fire. We at the Department of Natural Resources are committed to managing Georgia's wildlife. The work we're doing in Southwest Georgia will benefit non-game wildlife like red cock-headed woodpecker, gopher tortoise, indigo snake, Bachman sparrow. It'll also enhance habitat for our game species like deer, turkey, and quail for our hunters.